and all present here, respected panel members and my dear student managers. My name is Janar.
And I am Raghav Maheshwari.
And we are from River Mahanadi. So before introducing you to all to our topic, I would like to show you a video first.
जैसे दोस्त होता है
वैसे हर एक फ्रेंड जरूरी होता है
ऐसे हर एक फ्रेंड जरूरी होता है
कोई सुबह 5 बजे नीचे जगाए कोई रात को 3 बजे जान बचाए
एक तेरी खड़की में शेयरिंग करे
और एक तेरे बजट में स्पीकिंग करे
कोई नीचे से गेस्ट कोई होस्ट होता है पर
घड़ी का काम है पर कभी कभी कॉल करें
एक कभी कभी काम है और घड़ी घड़ी कॉल करें
गॉसिप का कोई घूमता फिरता सैटेलाइट कोई साथ रहे तो कर दे सब ऑलराइट
कोई एफर्टलेस कोई फोर्स होता है लेकिन हर एक फ्रेंड जरूरी होता
सो प्लीज गिव अस अ ह्यूज राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर ऑल आवर फ्रेंड्स अराउंड हियर सो आई थिंक यू मस्ट हैव ऑल नोन फॉर आवर टॉपिक एंड व्हिच इज एयरटेल So today we are going to tell you about a brief introduction on Airtel, its growth over the years, the marketing strategy which the company is using, the market size and the share of its competitor among the rest, the revenue and conclusion.
Next. Now we talk about introduction. It is a telecommunication industry. It was founded on 7/0/1995 by Sunil Bharti Mittal. The headquarters of Airtel is in New Delhi. The parent company of Airtel is Bharti Enterprises and Singtel in the ratio of 64% and 36%. It is currently operating in 18 countries and the world third largest mobile telecommunication company and the revenue of Airtel in 2018 is 49,800 crores.
So Airtel over the years, the inception of the Airtel company started with a company called Bharti Televentures Limited, which was founded in 1995. And in 1996, the company, for introducing market services in the telecom sector, they introduced a brand called Airtel. They started operating in Delhi and Himachal Pradesh. And in 2006, the company was renamed to Bharti Air Limited. And since all company requires to innovate after a certain period of time, especially for those who have been operating for more than 10 or 20 years, it was essential for company like Airtel to change the logo of it. That's why in 2010, when every company was rebranding itself, they also rebranded and reinvented itself. And in 2017, when we all know that the giant Jio arrived, the market was shocked by the tariff rates which was priced by Mukesh Ambani's Jio's. So they acquired tele services and Telenor to compete against them.
In the year 1995-96, they launched mobile services under Airtel in Delhi and Himachal Pradesh, and in the year 1997-98, became the first private telecom operator to get license in Madhya Pradesh, and in 1999, acquired JT Mobiles for providing cellular services operated in Punjab, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. In 2001, acquired 100% equity interest in Bharti Mobile Limited, which provided mobile services in the Kolkata also.
In 2002-2003, the company launched cellular mobile services in the circle of Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh West, Haryana and Gujarat. Until now, the company has established itself in most of the states of the country. And in 2003 and 2004, it also acquired new licenses to provide services in the extreme corner of our country like Jammu and Kashmir. And now in 2010, the company starts going global. In 2010, they acquired Zain Group's mobile for 70,000 crore INR to start operating in Africa. This was considered the biggest deal by an Indian telecom company at that time that left a footprint of Airtel all over the world. And in 2017, they bought Tata Teleservices and Telenor to compete against Jio.
Now talks about marketing strategies. They use promotion as a marketing tool to attract youth. They use catchy and trendy taglines like har ek friend zaruri hota hai and jo tera hai wo mera hai. Over the years, they have also signed big celebrities like Shah Rukh Khan and Sachin Tendulkar for endorsement, which helps to increase their subscribers. And for the product, they give many services like mobile services, prepaid services, and postpaid services. In mobile services, it provides voice and data services to its customers. And in prepaid services, recharge offers, family share packs, etc. In postpaid, bill payment, my plans, roaming plans, etc. Next slide.
Now coming to place, it has wide and extensive presence even in the remotest area. That's why Airtel right now, even after coming Jio, has acquired more than 30% share in the rural areas of India. It sells its product through distributors and retailers. There are many retailer and distributor of Airtel available even from grocery store into their specific outlet all over the country. It has collaborated with Walmart to increase its outlet all over the India. To collaborate with a big giant world famous Walmart was a big deal for him, and everybody knows about it that the Airtel is now available in the smallest to the biggest of the cities. And now coming to pricing, after the 4G plans, the validity are like 28 days, and the plans are given here which starts from 199 and goes up to 549 for 28 days, which was the maximum.
And the revenue and customer base. In 2016-17, the revenue of Airtel is 62,460. But in the year 2017-18, the revenue is declined and goes to 53,898. And in 2018-19, they go up to 49,800.
Now coming to the market size of the telecom sector wireless in our country. It is right now at 1,55,625 crore in INR. I know many of us will be wondering why there are only four competitors right now. I know, I have got the answer for you. Before 2017, which is prior Jio coming to our country, there used to be 9-10 telecom sector in which there were BSNL, MTNR, Tata Docomo and many more. After that, the tariff rates were so reduced by the Jio, so the only big companies like Airtel, Vodafone, Idea can consider himself to be standard against that giant. That's why many company got insolvent. BSNL is currently running in total loss, and that rest, which is Tata Docomo, which was bought up by Airtel. Even the big companies like Vodafone India, Idea had to merge to compete against Jio, and they are terribly failing in that to capture the market share. Jio has right now around 30% market share in the current quarter, which is June. Conclusion. The Airtel started from two states in India and is now the leading telecom company in 10 countries all over the world. For example, the company is smaller like Zambia, Tanzania, Congo, etc. From its innovative and catchy taglines, it has always attracted to you. Like I showed in the video, har ek friend zaruri hota hai. It is currently the fastest network in India according to Ookla.
These are the sources of information that we have taken our data. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all.